Jivox is a technology platform for personalization, right? So what many large brands are doing is they've kind of nailed down the ability to reach the right people for their product, and they've been doing that for years and years. So the question is, what's the next big knob you have to get better engagement? And I think what consumers are saying is, show me something relevant, not just one size fits all and so on. So it's increasingly brands are trying to figure out, how do you tailor content and creative specific to an individual, right? And so that's what personalization is all about. Now, it turns out to be quite expensive to do that, because you have to now produce content for every individual. And that's what our technology automates, is basically can produce many hundreds of thousands of versions of messaging and content and delivers it down to a specific consumer.
And what kind of media do you do this across?
So we do it across all media. So one of the big differentiators of our platform is that it's omni-channel. And we did that because, you know, a consumer isn't a consumer only when they're on the web or on their mobile device. They're a consumer all the time. And I think if you want to tell a story to them and you want to keep them engaged, you have to do so across all engagement points, including email, including when they're on your website. So we developed as an omni-channel platform so that the engagements can reach them wherever they are, but also personalize it to the environment, right? There are ways people, the mindset is different when they're on a social media platform versus when they're at work browsing the web, right? So we kind of think of their mindset also in making sure they get the right content.
So obviously marketeers have lots of very different objectives for their campaigns, you know, everything from more brand-based to direct response and so on. Where's the sweet spot for personalization? Which marketing objectives does personalization really deliver against?
Yeah, that's a very good question. You know, when brands started using personalization, it was primarily lower funnel activities, right? So it was basically conversion oriented, right? Somebody saw a product, show them the same product, and most likely they will convert. But increasingly, I think brands have shifted their thinking to saying it's not just about converting a consumer, but it's also about making them engage with the brand in a relevant way, right? So if you can, even when you're talking about your brand, if you can say it in a way that's engaging to the consumer. So I always use the example of an automaker, right? So if you're marketing an SUV, right, different people buy an SUV for different reasons, right? You might buy it because it has a great engine, it's very powerful, it can pull a trailer along, etc. Somebody else may be buying it because they can take the kids to skiing, right? So very different reasons. So I think even when you're building awareness about that SUV, thinking about the person that you're delivering the message to turns out increases engagement significantly. And some of the benchmarking work we've done, we've seen great lift even when you're just doing brand awareness, and significantly more so when you're trying to convert them.
Now, obviously, to personalize effectively, you need to know something about the person you're personalizing for. What do you personalize on the basis of? How do you know the appropriate characteristics or traits to base your personalization on?
That's a very good question. So identity is core to personalization. You have to know who the person is. But it turns out there's more to it, right? It's not just who you are, meaning you don't buy things just because of who you are, but it also tend to consider purchase based on where you are, what the context around you is, right? So we kind of look at different elements that influence the purchase mindset, or at least the engagement mindset, right? But identity is at the core of it, right? Because most consumers will share with brands that they trust enough information about them, right? So if you're a loyalty member for a big hotel chain, right? You're happy to share information with them because when you check in, you want to make sure they give you the right room and know your preferences, so you don't have to go over it all over again. So that mindset is why identity tied to that first party data becomes the most powerful weapon from a personalization standpoint. But so does weather, so does location. You know, surprisingly, we've seen even things like humidity levels. If you're selling skin cream, for example, it turns out that message does resonate, right? When it's dry, people think, oh, I gotta go get some skin cream. So, but identity is definitely at the core of it.
And how does personalization play into attribution? Are you able to test and learn, so you can demonstrate that different creative outputs, different approaches deliver better results for certain types of consumer?
Yes, exactly. In fact, a big part of dynamic creative optimization and personalization is knowing outcomes, right? And a big part of knowing outcomes is identity, because not only do you have to know the identity of the individual when you delivered a personalized creative to them, you also have to know the identity when they actually make a purchase, so they engage in some form of conversion. So identity is at the core of it, and in fact, we have a tool called customer journey optimization, which essentially tracks engagements of the consumer based on that single identity across channels and tries to figure out what the optimal creative message is for them in different channels. So a message that works well in one channel may not work very well in another channel. So there's a lot of optimization that can be done if you know the identity of the consumer and are tracking all the engagements they have with the brand.
And just a final few thoughts. Tell us how you see the next couple of years playing out. Do you think dynamic creative optimization, personalization are going to become ubiquitous? Or actually, do you think it'll remain the preserve of a select few? Where do you see the market being 2-3 years out?
Yeah, that's interesting. I mean, if you asked me that question 4 or 5 years ago, I would have probably said it's an interesting thing that some brands want to do in certain campaigns. But what we've seen recently is a couple of things. One is consumers want personalization, right? And at the end of the day, brands will do what consumers want, because otherwise consumers will just ignore them. And in fact, a lot of the surveys now of consumers, the ANA did some surveys, they're showing that consumers want brands to treat them as individuals, right? So that's a big part of it. The second is brands are seeing significant lift and ROI with their media spend when they deliver relevant creative. So we've seen this with our customers. 3 years ago used to be, oh, let's take this particular project and do DCO with it. Now we're seeing across the board, across the enterprise, every engagement should be personalized. So that's kind of where things are heading now.